And the hero makes his epic return. Hello, everybody. And I am back. So we can actually turn the music down. Not pause it, but turn it down. Actually, no, pause it. There we go. Anyway. I ate something really spicy and now I'm like kind of regretting it because I'm usually really strong resistant against spicy foods, but right now, not so much. I made it too spicy. I am bread. Come on. There you go. You're doing it. Good job. Man, this game sucks on ice. I hate trying to play this game without a controller. Excuse me. Do Rampage, Free Roam, Zero G, Cheese Hunt. Story Mode or Zero... I haven't tried Zero G yet. I have not yet tried Zero G's, and this might be really bad, because this might require a controller. Become toast! Oh boy, what's going on here? Oh, that's what was going on. I was behind the bed. Well, everything's floating. I can see why they meant zero G. What? I'm still stuck to the bread. Help! Let go! Okay. I don't think I can play this. I don't think I can play this because it's not. I can't turn. I can't turn. I cannot turn. I know there's a way you can turn, but I don't have a controller. The controller I bought was busted. Ha! Kerbal's Toast Program. Haha. Yes. Ah, damn it. This is all I can do. I can only go backwards or forwards. That's it. This game was not optimized for keyboard and mouse, I think. I just had that. Look, I can only do this! I can't do nothing else! God damn it! I can't do this game! Well, at least I can't do this. I can't do Space Toast. Literally cannot physically do Space Toast without a controller. Damn it. Let's try Cheese Hunt. Let's try the hunting of cheese. Okay, so I am cheese cracker, like one of the club crackers, right? Yes. Ooh, I'm a super fast. Oh. Oh, and I'm not so floppy. I'm very rigid. Also, okay. I was like, wait. Since I'm grabbing cheese, I don't have to worry about becoming toast. Whoa. Why did I have to pee after eating something hot? It was not a good idea. I'm so dumb. Oh, hey, there's a cheese. I almost went off the rails, and not in a good way. Let's see. Integrity? Yeah, that's not the same thing, edibility. So I'm guessing integrity. I gotta keep my poise while trying to grab pieces of cheese, so I'm gonna be like, oh, I'm gonna grab this cheese because my integrity is on the line. Oh, Jenga fall pot. Jenga fall pot. Give me my cheese, honky. Give me my cheese. Knock over the things. Knock all the things over. This isn't working. It's not working. What the hell does it take? There we go. I got the cheese down. I'm also very fast. Much faster than a regular slice of toast. Or bread, I mean. Give me my cheese! Give me my cheese! Get off it! Oh! Trying to screw me over on my cheese, are we? My cheese! So, where do we go next? Oh, there's a piece of stinky cheese over there. There's the toaster. Where's the toast? I loaf toast. Yay. Oh, there's another piece right over there. Where? So that's three pieces so far. Where's piece four and five? I'm gonna go over to the one. You know, it's super easy to knock over Jenga when you're playing it normally, but what the heck? It took so much effort to knock over that Jenga tower. What? Did they glue the pieces together? Would they glue the pieces together? Let's see, you loaf toast. Here we go. Up. Get. Alright, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Up. 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 Hup. 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 I think the cheese is getting in my way. Oh shit, no, yes. No! My attack grenade! I wasn't poised enough! I ain't poised. I just noticed my grip is almost dead. There we go. Ha 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 ha! See those slick moves? Yeah, slick. Like oil. Like oil. However, this is not very slick. There! There! Let's do some slick moves, Joe. Who's Joe? I don't know. Joe is the man inside my head. Tells me to go burn things. Yeah. I love Joe, but Joe's a bit violent. Joe, why do you make me do bad things? Flop, flop. There we go. Now we kind of just like bleh our way over here. Integrity decreasing. Playing YouTube bait. Integrity decreasing. No! My integrity! It's going down the shitter! No! It's the only way to get noticed. You can't play a game without it being of some form or way of being a YouTube bait. In all honesty. Oh, I don't even have to move. It's moving itself. Look at that. Look at that. I'm just pressing 3 and 1. 3 and 1. Oh, fuck! Oh, fuck. Well, that was lame. That was piss. That was lame. Piss and lame. Where was that cheese? Oh, it's up there. It's up there. Oh, hey. There's a cat food bowl over here or something. What does it say? Meow nom? Meow nom. Yep, meow nom. Nom meows. There's blood. There is blood in the cat dish. What? Can I zoom in? I want to see. Is that... That is very... That is blood! That is blood! So, yeah. That is much blood. Also, is this oven door going to open in on me when I'm trying to, like, walk up it? What? You say it's wet cat food, but I say it's blood. I think this guy was killing people and feeding them to his cat. Getting rid of the evidence slowly by feeding them to his cat. So, That's why he's going to the crazy house all the time, you know, to get psychological evaluations, because he's crazy. He's killing people and feeding them to his cat. Makes sense. Wet cat blood. Yeah, it might be cat blood. He might hate his cat. Also, this looks very hot. Can I actually turn on the heat? Can I turn off the heat? Let's turn up the heat. Yeah, actually, I can. That's kind of cool. That's a nice little detail. And it also means you better be careful. Okay, what's that? That looks like just dried coffee stains or dried poop. Dry poop. It's dry poop. Ah, go up. There we go. This one's much easier, I do have to say. Just don't let yourself drop. That's the only thing. That's the only thing you gotta do. Don't let yourself drop. Smashy, smashy. Dried coffee blood. Yes, that's exactly what it is. So now that I'm here, is there any more stinky cheese nearby? Oh, that's the one I've seen before. You know what? My gamer instincts are telling me to go up there. Let me get a few noodles in. As I kind of like wibble wobble for no reason. I haven't done anything. I didn't press any buttons. Oh, plate. Oh, plate. You're going to get me killed and I don't like it. Let's see if I can actually make this. Can I get up there? Ah. Let me reset my bar here. And up, please. Hey, up, up. Thank you. Do 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 do. Almost there. Almost there. Oh, almost lost it. Almost lost it. There we go. Was my gamer instincts right? Holy fuck! No, they were not. But. Please stop messing with me, camera. You're killing me. So let me edge my edge. Let me edge my edge. Oh, I was almost right. So there's one there, and there's one over there. So all I have to do is kind of shimmy my way across the wall and get over there. And this is much easier with a piece of cracker that doesn't freaking flop and bend like my fucking... I'm not gonna finish that sentence. Hold on. I can't see what I'm doing. Let's see now. Let's get over near the wall and press 2 and then move on. Yeah. Ah. I can't. Camera. Come here, camera. Oh. Good. Dude. I'm not. Like I said, I'm not finishing that sentence. No way. No way. Nope. No, not happening. Okay. Stop it. Stop! Step!
Step!
There we go. Ooh, stop pressing the wrong button, Skids! You idiot! You moron! You douche! You dumbass! You asshat! Fudge nutter! No, fudge! No! Everything going to hell because I pressed the wrong button! Oh, stop flopping! Everybody do the flop. Everybody do the flop. Because I'm flopping hard. Now I'm just pushing the cheese. I'm not cutting it, I'm just pushing it. So, there's one right there, right? Yeah, I can see it's cheese fumes. I can see the cheese fumes. Yes. Yes, the cheese fumes. I like cutting at that. Okay, here we go. Over. Oh. I'm too high. I'm not high. Oh, how did I lose integrity? I caught on to it. That sucked. You suck, game. You suck. Ooh, box. Okay, make our way, make our way slowly over yonder. So, yeah. Can I, like, throw myself over yonder? It did take some of my integrity to do that. It took all of my integrity! Not my integrity, I need that. As a streamer and a YouTuber, I need my integrity, otherwise I'm just a sellout, just like the Game Grumps. Oh ho ho! Nah, I actually love the Game Grumps. But, in all honesty, it does feel like they do more marketing than anything else anymore. But, it doesn't mean I don't love them. I mean, they're trying to make money, and I know money does make the world go round, very much so. Ding! Zing! Zing ding. Please don't kill me now. I am too close to die. Ooh, ooh, ooh. That's a good way. Egged! I got egg on my face! I got egg all over my face. Oh no, I got eggshells stuck to me! I'm probably the grossest cracker right now. No! Out of my way, eggshells! Out of my way! Ah! Eh! Ah! Eh! Ah! Eh! Ooh! Ah! You! Ah! Oh, come on! Come the fudge on! Oh, with 25% integrity, can I finish this? If I can't finish it, I will be very much the mad. Yeah, meh. I'm pressing the wrong buttons. I'm not paying enough attention. I'm gonna have to climb up the table. Oh, chat. Oh. You do like it in the face, huh? Huh? Zinging me now? You're zinging me? Zing? Zing-a-ding-a-ling-a-ding? Too much zings on my part. Stop zinging me. I'm not electricity. You can't zing me. I'm the Skids. Can't fire me. I'm Gumby, goddammit. Whoa, camera! Whoa, camera, whoa, I'm gonna be sick. Oh, stop. Why? Fuck! Camera! Motherfucker. Ya mother humper. Why the hell did the camera do that to me? Totally lost integrity. Now, if I take one more hit, I'm going to die. So I gotta do this in one go. I'm getting nervous. I'm getting nervous. Yes. Hold on. Three. I'm holding down to three. I am holding down to three. I am holding there. No. Oh, fucking thank you. Jabbus. Oh! What?! You dirty, dirty motherfuckers! You sons of bitches! You lick the inside of the pig's anus! Turning into fucking Porky Pig over here. That's all, folks. Mother Humper! How did that make me lose integrity? How? Earlier I smashed the plate. I didn't lose integrity. This is bullshit. Now yeah, that's a grade A. That's some grade A bullshit right there. After 15 minutes of getting through that stupid place, and I ended up not getting Oh, you son of a bitch! No. Just no. Smashing plates? That's quite unorthodox. Smashing jars of jelly? Unorthodox, you lose integrity. Did I really lose integrity on the plate? Well, I had no other choice. There was no way I could. How was I supposed to climb that stupid jar of freaking jelly? I didn't know. I didn't know breaking something would make me lose integrity. Because I was screw you, game. That was my victory. That was my victory! And you stole it away from me! Yeah, stress. Crazy. People killing people. Stuff like that. Bread becoming toast. The world going mad. I could have gone wrong, but I didn't know! I didn't know. How was I supposed to know? I was just like, I'll just smash this jar here, and then I'll be on my merry way grabbing the last slice of cheese, because I'm all in the blue and I'm all in the clear, but no! No, I was not. So I gotta make this stupid floppy piece of shit into toast. Ah! No! It begins. Oh, no. Oh, no. The real rage begins now. Floppy ass piece of shit. Oh, no! No. Okay. Made it to the thing with the least amount of integrity lost. So let's get up. Somebody's been drinking real heavily, methinks. Whoa! Oh, get out of here, beer bottles. I'm not an alcoholic, you're an alcoholic. No! Don't flop me, bro. Let's get over here. There we go. My integrity has been saved. Flop, mother humper, flop, mother humper. Hold on, I need to take a rest. Not a rest, not a break, not a death. Not a death, just a rest. Not a death, not a breath. I need a breath, I need grip. So hump the bat box for a moment and give everybody a freaking headache by jabbing their head against the table. Bad toast. Aha! Made it! Get out of my way! I'm not drunk. You're drunk. Something. My friend just. The friend that I told you about that totally destroyed, or not destroyed, but totally, froze up during the thing yesterday is now messaging me, and I cannot tell what the message says because I am too busy playing a game where I am a piece of toast. Or a game where I'm a piece of bread trying to become toast because it's mentally insane. Okay. Oh, fuck! No! Don't let me down! Don't let me down, Clarice. I can't even think of that sound! No. Oh, no. I can't see where I'm going. I can't see what I'm doing. Somebody save me. No! Fuck the world! Fuck it hard! Fuck it with the rubber hose of death! And spikes! Spikes and rubber! Oh no. I'm not gonna make it. Up! 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 You asshole! You fucking asshole! Why aren't you doing my things that I command you to do, you fuck? Fuck it. Mother of Humvers of Dove God. Mother cunt. Bitch ass. Fucker. Duck. I eat my noodles angrily. It's almost done. Almost done, noodles. I eat angrily. Get off me. That was badass. Just like, get the fuck off me. Cat. Yeah, no, you know, that's probably his cat. You know, stop. Whoa, what is going on with my jiggles? What is with the jiggles? Oh, by the way, FYI, my jester name was, Jiggles, the Giggling Juggling Jester, yesterday. Yes. I pressed the wrong button. Piss! Oh, pissy piss. But I lost only 1% of my integrity. This is good, y'all. But I can't get up. Up. Grab. Smashing things. Smashing things in my rage. I'm an angry alcoholic. Alcoholism ruins families! It surely does. My grandfather was an alcoholic. I didn't see much of my grandfather because my parents kept me far away from my alcoholic grandfather. Oh, this is so bad. Alcoholism, woo. Not very, not really feeling that woo. Not really feeling it. Nope, not feeling any woos for I Am Bread either. Yes! Ha! No! No, you jiggly bastard! You jiggly bastard! Get up there, you jiggles! I'm really feeling it! I'm really feeling it! What's the name of that game with that character? It's a meme. All I know is the meme, and he's in Brawl. That's all I know. Whoa! Hey, now! You're an all-star. Please don't fall in oblivion. Okay. Nope. Oh, there we go. Avoid the wall mold. Because this guy is fucking disgusting. Oh, I got wall mold on my freaking bread. Ew. 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 I'm back where the candy is. Chat, I'm confused. I don't know what you guys are talking about. Just because I grabbed a print. Just because I grabbed a print. You fucking print. You goddamn print. Fuck prints, man. Fuck them. What's a print ever done for a human? Whatever has a fucking print ever done for a human? Nothing. Except for give us oxygen. But besides that, they're fucking useless. Yes, I know the neighbor dogs are loud. I hate living here. I got loud parents. I got loud fucking neighbor dogs because my neighbors are fucking assholes. And I I live next to a kind of a busy road, so sometimes there's some really, really loud motorcycles going by. Ooh. Ooh, get out of there. I'm stuck. Ugh. Stuck no more, I am. I have to deal with this all the time. All the time. You have no idea. Like, I'll be awake maybe at 3 a.m. And then all four, there's four of them out there in a small kennel. Four of them, two per, like this, like the cage is sectioned off so that there's two in each one. And I have to listen to them, sometimes all four of them bowing and barking and mostly just bowing because they're freaking hound dogs. No, stop. I somehow stopped it. But, yeah, so it's their hound dogs. They are more annoying than regular dogs because bowing or baying or whatever you, however you pronounce it, is the worst thing since freaking, like, nails on a chalkboard. Maybe just as bad as that. Especially at late in the night. And, fuck! Ah! Oh my god, one mistake and you're all, it's all over. It's all over. One mistake and everything just goes to shit. Anyway, yes, my neighbors don't care because they claim they're hunting dogs and they never take them out hunting. They just leave them outside in the elements, giving them barely a doghouse or letting them walk into the garage, I guess. But they don't ever clean the cage slash, you know, outdoor cage or whatever. So it always smells like fucking piss and urine during the summertime, and I get, since my window is right next to them, I get to smell that if I try to open my window sometimes. And I'm not allowed to fucking call nobody. I have a really tough time talking to people about that sort of thing. Like, I'm naturally kind of like shy when it comes to confrontation. I'm really bad at it, so I haven't been able to talk to them. And I can't call nobody because my parents won't let me call nobody because they're like, well, our dog doesn't have any shots, so we don't want to start nothing with the neighbors. It's like, what the fuck? How is this even legal? I can't call. I'm not allowed to call. Not the plant! Not the green! You fucking cocksucking plant! You mother of fucks! You are the worst plant in the name of a plants. You have done this twice to me, plant. I curse thee. I curse thee to oblivion. I curse thee to the fucking hairy hells of fucking Satan's anus. Motherfucker. Mother. Humping son of a bitch. So. Ah. How many times am I going to be foiled by the same thing over and over and over again before I learn? Never to trust the houseplant. Never trust the houseplant! They're evil. Secretly plotting your death and demise before you even know it. You'll be fucking hung by a planter. One of those planters that they hang from. You'll be hanging from it, just like in a noose. Little do you know. Little do you know, plants are devising a plan to take us over. They're sick and tired of us taking over their land. Oh, I lost my grip! No! Slid down in the bed crack. Help! There's nothing but used condoms and a dildo back here! Help me! Ah! Sliding up. You goddamn floppy motherfuck! I got toenails all over me again! No, it's happening again! No! I was so confident going in this, and then everything just went to hell. I keep nothing underneath my bed but blankets. Chat. And dust bunnies. I have dust bunnies who live underneath my bed. Ah! I hate this game. I hate it so freaking much. I have made no progress since I've started this game. Absolutely zero. Ah! Let me up there. I'm contorting my fingers. Hump the... Get my grip back by, like, twitching. Twitch, twitch. Twitchy twitch. Just like Pinkie Pie. Oh, dropping some references. Dropping all them references. There they are again. Doesn't matter what time of day, it's arr time. It's arr time. Can I please get rid of this cop before it murders me dead? Get out of here. No smashy smashy for that. No! I didn't let go of the button! It just dropped me like a freaking hot potato. Not potato. Ooh, that reminds me. I have a story to tell about hot potato. Ah! Give me a sec. Okay. Everything calm down for a minute. Don't trust the houseplant! Don't trust the houseplant! Anyway, so a game of hot potato. My friends, a couple of years back, like 3 or 4 years back, and this also involves John, my accomplice in juggling. Him and his brothers, they were playing hot potato, right? Okay, but they were playing hot potato with a real burning ember. Okay, and it was about fall time, so I was wearing my jacket. Still semi cold out. So they were playing hot potato with a live coal from a fire that we were having, and I wanted no part of it. So when they tried tossing it to me, and they were like, "It's not that bad. You just toss it. You don't." I'm like, "I don't know. I'm not doing it." And so I smacked it away. Right? I smacked that burning ember that was coming at me away. I was like, "No, I'm not playing this game. Get out of here." 5 minutes later. I was smelling burning, what smelled like burning plastic for a while, and 5 minutes later, my friend John looks at me, and he says, "Dude, you're on fire!" And I'm like, "What?" And I look down, and there's smoke coming out of my pocket and my jacket, out of the neck hole of my jacket, and I'm like, "Holy fucking shit!" And I fucking rip the jacket off. A chunk of the ember had flew into my pocket when I hit it. And it almost caught me on fire. I had a giant burning jacket and didn't know what the jacket survived. And I survived. Ha ha! And I survived. Oh yeah, I gotta go to that iron. That's right. And I survived. I was... No, plainly I didn't survive because you can't even hear what I'm saying. I'm a ghost playing a video game! Woo! But I didn't... obtain any injuries, and my jacket just... We were able to get the burning embers out of the jacket, and they actually burnt a hole all the way through the jacket, the lining of the jacket, and just left a big hole on the inside of the jacket. But the jacket itself didn't catch fire. Fuck! A duck with a rubber mallet. With a rubber mallet. Fuck that duck with a rubber mallet, and fuck this game with it too. So yeah, that's the story of me almost catching on fire one time. And, still have that jacket. Still have the jackets. My dad wears it now because, I don't wear fucking the damn thing. It's got a big hole in it. All the stuffing's coming out of it. My dad doesn't care. Can we stop? There we go. No. No. No, why? Why would you do this to me? Let me just collect all the hairs and all the fucking... I'm not losing an edibility here. Are you telling me? Are you telling me the bed was safe, but the pillows were not? The pillows were not because he clipped all his toenails on his pillows. But the bed sheets are fine, except for, some band-aids, and some nail clippings over there. So the pillows aren't... My son almost burnt to death in this jacket. Interesting. After that, I wouldn't trust those guys with a hot potato game ever again. I'm like, I'm not even touching it. I'm going to avoid whatever you throw at me from now on. He wouldn't care. You only actually know he might because, I'm losing. I lost a ton of integrity there just now. Now I got toenails all over me again. Or integrity, I mean edibility. Whatever. Same difference. Anyway, the only time I've ever seen my dad ever, show any kind of, like, love, really, in the longest of time, like, years and years since I was, like, 3 or something, was, when I was literally on my deathbed, a few years ago, I think it was about 4 years ago now, 2013, I think it was. So about four years ago now. I ended up getting a really bad tooth infection. And it got so bad that I was taking hydrocodones. And it wouldn't, like, at first it was touching the pain, but it was after, like, a couple times of taking the pain pills, I ended up they stopped working, and I ended up getting the worst pain I've ever had in my life was this tooth infection. I've never been more miserable than when I had that tooth infection. It was the way the dentist repaired it. It was horribly done. There was, like, germs or something inside the tooth, and when he fixed it up, the root kept getting infected over and over again, like, 3 times, and, by the third time I was taking I can't remember, but it was, like, the second time it got infected, I was taking hydrocodones and ibuprofen at the same time, because it was not touching barely the pain. Shit. Damn, gonna have to wait it out here. So I ended up taking a ton of hydrocodones and ton of ibuprofen, and way more than the recommended amount. And the tooth infection went away, but I slowly started feeling really weak after a couple weeks, like a week or two after the tooth infection. I was like, I can't. I skipped a couple of days of work even because I felt so weak and tired all the time. And one day, about 2 weeks later, I woke up, got up out of bed and got really dizzy. And I tried to walk downstairs and almost passed out from walking down the stairs. And when I got downstairs, I ended up sitting down in the chair, and I went to my parents. I'm like, I'm not feeling really well. I almost passed out when I went down the stairs. And they come into the room, and both of them, each one of them, who my mom first came into the room, and she looked at me, and her fucking jaw hit the floor, and she started, like, she gasped and cried out, and I was apparently so pale that I would look like a ghost. Like, I was the purest of white. I was about as white as that pin. I don't know. I never looked in the mirror, but apparently I was so white, I was as white as a ghost. They claim that they've never seen a person more white than a corpse. A corpse would have been just as white. And they both were in shock. They were both worried about me. So they were going to take me to the hospital, and they brought me out to the van, and as I was, they tried to put me in the van. The van was actually locked because the van was brought. They brought it to the city not the, like the day after, before or something like that. So that's why it was locked. Damn it! I can never make that hit jump. I cannot make that jump. I cannot. I can't. I can't. I'm dancing around the chair now. Fuck this game. How's anyone ever beat this game? So I ended up actually standing there for too long. I couldn't stand up for long. So I actually ended up passing out, standing up, waiting for them to unlock the car. My mom go, the last thing I remember before I hit the ground was, my mom going, "Are you okay?" And I said, "I don't know." And that was the last thing I remembered before I hit the ground. And, yeah, I kind of half passed out standing up there. And what happened was, the next thing I remember, I was sitting in the van, with my dad giving me a glass of water to, help me out a little bit. And they had called 911 to get me to the hospital. And funny story, but the hospital in the nearby city of Rome, never, ever go to the Rome hospital in Rome, New York. Because it is run by fucking imbeciles. Let's see. So it was run by fucking imbeciles, and instead of having them take me to the Rome hospital, I took them, had them take me to a hospital that was 45 minutes away. They were like, "Are you sure you don't want to go to the nearby hospital?" I'm like, I don't trust these people with my with my health and on my deathbed, basically. So take me to St. Luke's, which is in Utica. And I ended up going to Utica. I went to the hospital there, and they did some tests on me, and they said, you were bleeding internally. So that, I was actually, had been bleeding internally for 2 weeks. You want to know why I was bleeding internally for 2 weeks? Because I overdosed on ibuprofen. Ibuprofen is really strong. It can really fuck up your intestines. And it fucked up mine because I was like taking 1,000 milligrams every like 3 or 4 hours. And because of that, because I was taking way over the dose that they recommended, it ate away a hole in my lower intestine or upper intestine and my stomach. And I ended up having, how many units? It was like 8 or 9 units of blood pumped into me over the course of, over the course of 24 hours, which is a lot of blood. That's a lot of blood for a person to take in such a short amount of time. So I was like heavy blood loss, like really heavy blood amount of blood loss there. And, they did a thing to check my intestines. Like they put a camera inside me, checked my intestines, and they were like, "Yeah, you have 2 ulcers inside, one inside your intestines, one inside your stomach." They had to give me some stuff that closed up the holes. They then gave me 8 or 9 units of blood over like the course of 24 hours / 48 hours. And 2 days later, I was out of the hospital because I was feeling fine. I was feeling just fine after that. After they pumped blood into me and fixed the holes in my gut, I was feeling perky. I was like, by day three, I was like, "Let me out of here. I want to go do things again. I'm alive. Let me out." Yeah, but they did a couple more tests that day, and they let me out by day 3. So yeah, that was my story of my near death. My near death. So where do I gotta go now? I might be going the wrong way. I think I might actually supposed to be under that lamp. But I've been trying to go for this iron this entire time. So yeah, that's my story of my near death. Moral is, don't fuck with ibuprofen, and also don't fuck with this game because it fucking hates people. Why did you eject? Why did you eject from the pool, you fucking dickweed? Dickweed. Okay, I'm gonna try one more time. I'm gonna go around the other way this time. Because this has not worked out. So I'm gonna try to go to that lamp this time. And not taking that immortality. Fuck that. I can do this. So story time with Skids. Yeah, but that, like I said, I kind of got a little a sidetrack, but that's the only time I've ever heard my dad say in a, like any memory at all, I love you. That was the only time. Pretty much on my deathbed. Should have recorded it. Should have got my phone out and recorded it. That way I could have been like, if every time, anytime I go and be like, you're not very loving to me, remember this? I'll record it. I had a recording of him saying I love you and then kind of blackmail him with it every time I want. Yeah. That was the closest I ever been to death, was dying of blood loss. I apparently checking your stool is a good idea. I didn't know this, okay? It sounds gross, and it really is, but yeah, the god doctor said if you have a very dark, very strange smelling stool, that means you have blood in your stool. And I'm like, oh, well, gross. Great. Wonderful. That's peachy keen. Great story, by the way, Mr. Skids. Not only have you made everybody in your chat panic, but you've also grossed them out. Good job. Tonk. I'm fine. Yes, I know, chat. I'm fine now. It was years ago. It was my own mistake. I don't really blame the dentist. I mean, the dentist wasn't that great, but I don't blame the dentist because he was just kind of doing his job, and my teeth were fucked up. It had a big hole in it anyway, a big cavity, and my insurance doesn't cover... Medicaid is really fucking stupid. I mean, really stupid when it comes to dental. The dental with Medicaid is... you can get root canals, and you can get, ooh, wow, I just ejected from the wall. You can get fillings for any tooth. However, root canals you can only get for your front teeth, but not your molars. Because, in their words, your molars aren't important enough to spend, like, $200 on the fix. Get, this is exactly their words. How fucking stupid is that? Isn't that the stupidest fucking thing you've ever heard, chat? The things that you chew your food with aren't important enough to spend $200 on. Yes, group hugs. Group huggles, yay. Chat is grouping hugging me. Huggings! The huggings! All the huggings! Yay, hugs! I, in fact, have two large cavities in a couple of my teeth, and I have not gone to the dentist for them because I fucked up a dentist appointment, and because I fucked up the dentist appointment, I now owe them $50, and I don't have $50 to go and get those fixed with. And even if they do fix them, they might tell me, or even if I do go to the dentist, they might tell me they're too far gone to repair them, and I might not be able to get, like, a, what do you call it, root canal. Don't think I can get a root canal for them. So I have two holes in my teeth. The tooth that got infected, they ripped out, by the way. They pulled out that tooth. And because of that tooth, it was missing. The other two teeth around it, because I don't think I brush enough in that area, because I didn't realize you're supposed to brush in that area a lot, because food gets caught where your tooth is missing. But because of that, I have now two big cavities there that I can't do nothing with. They don't really bother me. They don't hurt. So it's not that big an issue. It was because the dentist filled in that one tooth that I kept getting infected. Because the germs had no place to go or whatever. I'm not sure what kept happening. But the root kept getting infected over and over again because it was filled in wrong or... I don't know. They never explained it to me. I think it was a cover-up. I think he messed up or something. But no other dentist would tell me why I was getting tooth infections. They're just like, oh, hey, we need to rip these teeth out. Like I said, I can't fix them, chat. I can't get them fixed. I can't afford the $50 that costs that. And besides, even if they fill them in, even after I paid the fine of missing my appointment and not calling in, even if I pay that for $50, they might tell me the only thing we can do is either take them out or fill them in. And I don't want to do either, in all honesty. I don't want to do either. Both sound like horrible ideas just because Medicaid is fucking bunch of assholes. They're not willing to spend money trying to cheap out on money. Because our health system's so damn screwed up. And there's only two dentists' offices in this area that take my insurance. Because a lot of dentists don't take insurance. Because they don't get money right away. See? It takes a little while to get money from the insurance company. And because it takes a while, a lot of dentists deny wanting to take insurance because they're greedy fucktards. And because of that reason, I can only go to two dentists. I don't trust the first one because they're the ones that fucked up my teeth to begin with. And the second guy I owe money to. So, not much I can do. Totally screwed. I just want... What's in here? I turned it into the dog from that one thing. I would like to get replacement teeth for the one that I ended up losing. I want to replace my teeth so bad. Also, that angle is horrible. Hey, we're right near the lamp. Hopefully this works. No. Do I have to be up against it? Am I not close enough to it? I think I have to get up there and, like, bring it down or something. Oh, hey. Can I climb up there? Yes, I can. I can climb up there and knock this lamp down by dropping on top of it, I hope. Otherwise, I might miss. I'll miss and accidentally go flying off onto the floor. That is wall mildew. Okay. The rainbow. There's the rainbow again. So one day I plan on, like, replacing the teeth that I ended up losing. One day. If I ever make fucking money. Like, I never had... The problem is I don't have enough money to replace the teeth with. And I don't have enough money to get a root canal. For the teeth that I have already, so I've been really being very super careful with my teeth lately. I've been brushing them twice a day, using floss all the time, using mouthwash all the time, and it's been doing a really good job protecting my teeth. My teethies! Man, I've been talking silly stories in my life for a long while here, for like the last, 30 minutes I've been talking stories? Telling stories, talk about my life. Things of my life, things that have happened in my life. The first ever dentist I ever went to was a fucking quack who was from Tennessee who kept insulting me, kept calling me pudding head. Pudding head. Hey, you're a rot pudding head. Skid's teeth. Let's talk about Skid's teeth for the whole stream. Yeah, literally my freaking first dentist. I had a big hole in my tooth. Okay, that's the reason why I, God damn it. The reason why I went to the dentist in the first goddamn place was to get my t that tooth filled because I noticed I was getting a big cavity there. And instead of, fixing the tooth that had a problem, they were like, "Oh, hey, the first dentist I ever saw was like, oh, well, your wisdom teeth are all fucked up and they ain't doing nothing for you, so let's pull a couple of your wisdom teeth. Because you're a right pudding head, and since you got a pudding head because you're young yet, it's better to get rid of your wisdom teeth now before they become a problem later on in your age." And he had that accent. He had the freaking southern accent and everything, the Tennessee accent. And, so yeah, he mocked me the entire time. Hold on, I wanna try to make this jump. Fuck! God damn it! Alright. So, he mocked me, like I said, he mocked me the entire time I was there in the fucking office. He ripped out my tooth, one of my wisdom teeth, just one, and to make matters worse, he did not give me any pain pills. After the Novocaine wore off, felt like fucking hell. I was in so much pain. And they wouldn't give me goddamn nothing for my pain. They didn't give me a goddamn thing for my pain. It was awful too. Almost as bad as the tooth infection. Almost. Not quite. But it was bad. It made me grumpy. And they didn't even give me Tylenol or ibuprofen or anything like that. What the fuck? So I ended up, luckily, one of my parents had an OxyContin, or not OxyContin, oxycodone, from their tooth surgery, and they gave it to me, and I was fine for the rest of the day. I was in happy land. Woo! I was all kinds of cheerful and happy. Nothing got me down. I was just like, yay, life is grand! Oxycontin, or oxycodone. What hell of a drug. I wouldn't recommend it, though. I wouldn't. I only took the one, so don't worry. I'm not addicted to them. I'm not addicted, chat. I'm not a druggie. Ha! Oh! Oh, it didn't move it far enough! What the hell? Do I just climb it? Can I just climb the damn thing instead of dropping down on it? It just seems rather silly that I keep doing this. Whoa, Nelly! Whoa, ride 'em, cowboy! Skids confirmed for drug addict. No, I'm not a druggie. Stop! Don't call me a druggie. I ain't a druggie. I'm a cowboy. Damn it! I'm a bad cowboy. I'm not a gay cowboy either. Nope. I'm not from Brokeback Mountain. Whoa! Fling me far, far, far away. I'm dancing with this lamp. Ah! Scat, scat, skiddly-dee-dee-dee. I was just thinking that, but I don't know if I have to be directly under it, the lamp. I'm not a gay cowboy. Ah! Come on. Come on. No, no, don't, no, no. No! Help me! Give me the goddamn lamp! I'm not a gay cowboy, no. I'm not a gay cowboy. I'm different. I'm a bisexual cowboy. Ah! Very good! Oh my god! over here. I'm waiting for chat to catch up so they can be like, oh my. Yeah, it doesn't sound as good as a gay... It doesn't roll off the tongue as well as Gabe Cowboy does it. Ah, fuck me. Okay, can I, like, now edge my edge over this edge? God damn this fucking light! Ah, god damn this camera, god damn this game! What does do? Oh! Can I, like, break the computer with that China thing? Maybe? I don't know. This is getting really ridiculous. This is getting redonkulous. I could try going for the iron, but I was hoping... Krillin isn't a gay cowboy! Can I get onto that chair and climb my way to the iron? Because this lamp shit ain't working for me. Nope, ain't working for me. What kind of computer is this? Hold on. Is this a Compaq? Fuck, what do they call these types of computers? This goddamn big-ass piece of crap 1990s model computer. I thought maybe I was gonna hit the floor there for a second. That would have... I think my rage would have been... unbound. Kinda like Broly. I can't wait. There is one thing I cannot wait for. And that is... when Team 4 Star does the Broly episodes. Oh! Come the fuck on! Ah! Fuck! Everything! Invincibility is looking fucking rather tempting right now. Nope. One more. This is my last attempt. Period. End of discussion. Otherwise, if I don't make it on this last attempt, it is invincibility time. No. Doesn't count. Does not count, mate. Does not count. Oh, what the fuck? Doesn't count. I can't do OTG. He's just got that, like, really low voice that I cannot replicate. No. Yes, thank you, chat. Oh, fuck. Oh, the cat saved me. The cat picture saved me. Thank you, kitty. Now rest in hell. Excuse me. I don't know if Crow came back online. He's awfully late. He might not show up tonight. That would suck. I really do want to play his game. But if he doesn't show up, then we'll just have to play it tomorrow. It is getting kind of late. Might have to play it tomorrow. Or we have the... of the light, or Ori of the blind forest, Ori of the light, Oreos of the light kind, Oreos of the double stuffed. Ah, hey, now I got myself wanting Oreos. God damn it! Fuck! God damn it! Get out of here, houseplant. Nobody trusts you. I'm never trusting a houseplant ever again, thanks to you. Fucking houseplants trying to plant ruin, like. Everybody's all scared about lizardmen and zombies taking over the world and the Illuminati. The fucking houseplants is what we gotta be worried about. It's like 90% of homes have fucking houseplants. I know, there's so many types of British English accents that there's just, oh, it's so hard to like replicate them all. There's like the posh like one that kind of like London, kind of like, and then there's like the good day, governor. Hey, governor. Oi, what you doing, gov? Stuff. I can't do that one very well, but that's like, but like the grimy like Welsh. I don't know, not Welsh, but very like low level. Not low level. Oh. Low income one, like the seedy type from the seedy type of town name accent. Kind of like how we have our southern accent. And it's like, oh yeah, yeehaw! And they got the, oi, hoi, what you doing around here, mate? Kind of accent. I can do the Scottish and Irish. Oh, top of the morning to you. This is my over-the-top Irish accent. Quite over the top. I can't hold it for very long. I gotta keep thinking of what I'm going to be saying next. Otherwise, I screw it up. My Irish accent, or my Scottish. Ugh. Yeah, that's it. It's just that. That's it. That's all the Irish accent you get. Ugh. Ugh. Will it make? Are you getting me eggs in a basket? If you're coming here for non-offensive stream material, you've come to the wrong place. Getting me haggis in a basket. And that you do know that the Irish and the Scottish would be offended if you called them English. Highly offended, chat. They do not like being considered in the same category. There's been a lot of bad blood between those two. Because that would be a bad idea, chat, getting on the skateboard. That would be a bad idea. Bad. Well, I turned into Matthew McConaughey. I don't know why. Yeah, I was in that movie Contact. But I didn't do very. I don't know why they sent me the dad figure. With nice washboard abs, and how could I say no? Especially that $1 million deal that we had going. Yep. Can't turn down a $1 million deal, can you? Hey. Now I'll just ride my boat all over the world. Ah, fuck! Concentration time. Yeah. Fuck! What are you doing? Camera's not recording. God damn it. A grip, a grip. No, fuck! No, it was like Pingle. It was like Pingle or Jingo or whatever that game is. Oh, from goddamn Price is Right. I hate it. This game. Why? Why? Where did it all go wrong? I'm trying to think how it all went wrong. How? Ha, almost there. Almost there. Thank fucking Christ. It was like tingle. It was like tingle. Oh no. Not a tingle. Woohoo! Link! You almost touched my tingle bottle! Woohoo! God, what is wrong with me? Oh. No. I meant like that Pingle game or whatever. Holy shit, what the fuck just happened? My bread just freaked out. My fucking bread just had an aneurysm. Or a seizure, maybe. It's the Price is Right game where they've dropped the little discus inside the thing and it hits the pegs as it goes down. Damn you, Blake. What is that game called? Now it's killing me. Is it really called Pingle? Pangle? I can't remember now. Oh no. Oh, I'm stuck. Please, chat, help me out. Help. Help, chat. Help. Help me. It's exactly what I was saying yesterday during the fucking show, the show we were doing. So that it's like I was telling my friends, I'm trying to whisper to him, help me, please, help. I'm dying out here. No, not Pringles. Not Pringles. Whoa, that's a weird camera feature. Why is that a thing? Okay. We're back here now. At least. I don't think that light's given off enough heat. Also, why the hell is that... Why is the computer screen, like, super pixely grimy? That's weird. What is this? Grabbing straight? Curling iron? Is that a curling iron? This guy's got a curling iron. Why has this guy got a curling iron? It just occurred to me. Why does he have a curling iron? He's a guy, right? He's a Mr. Whatever. Why has he got a curling iron? Is that a curl? That's a curling iron. Why on God's green earth does he have a curling iron? He has a curling iron. Curling iron. Yeah, a curling iron without a wire. So it's a battery operated curling iron? What? That makes no sense. Why? Why would he have a non-battery operated $2 million? Straightener, maybe? I can't pick it up, it's too big. A straightener? Well, a straightener. I'd never heard of a straightener before. Whoa, sliding on the plate. Sliding on the plate. I have two paths. I can try the iron again, or I can go up there, try exploding the computer, and yeah, let's... You know what? This might have the chance to work. If it doesn't work... Oh, don't do that! That was scary as all... That was more scary than That was more scary than fucking some actual horror games that moment. So you can actually use a curling iron to straighten your hair. That's kind of an oxymoron. Well, not oxymoron. No, irony. Ha ha! Get it? Irony. Curling iron. Ha ha! Oh, ha ha! King of comedy, sitting right here, without actually having only three fans. Stop. Okay, can I like edge this off the goddamn, off the edge this off its edge, please? This might be more, trouble than I thought it would be. Especially with that fucking wall somehow, like, making me, all grossy. I'm not even touching that wall and it was making me all gross. Ha! Well, shit. Well, that didn't work. Valiant effort, Sir Corey, or I mean, Sir Skids, but no. Nothing for you. Get your mind out of the gutter, chat! Alright. Our last chance is here at the iron. That was very anticlimactic, yes. On the chair! Get on the chair! Get on the chair, you bitch! I didn't say nothing. I don't know what you're talking about, chat. Certainly didn't say anything inappropriate that might have been my real name or anything like that. I'm wiggling on the chair. I could just get the chair to flop in that right direction, it wouldn't be so hard. I wouldn't have to try flinging myself. Hold on. I'm gonna reattempt this. Drop down. I'm trying to be really, really safe right now. Really safe. Like, 5 condoms worth of safety got going on here. K. Ah. Come on, damn it. Get. Skip fucking with me. Ah. Chair. Why do you hate me so? Oh, why, camera? Why does camera hate me, too? The camera hates me. The fucking chair hates me. Everything hates me. Now the camera won't get out from over there. Chat says it can't get its mind out of its gut or it's firmly planted there. Like a fucking tree. Like a goddamn pine cone that's taken root in your gutters. You are exactly that. I'm surprised chat hasn't been like, well, you're the one talking about condoms, Mr. Skids. Ah! Don't want to die! Don't want to die! Don't want to die! Please! Just! Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! Damn, this is a goddamn shit! Ah! Eh. Trying to like grab onto the chair and push it over. Wait, I just realized something. That doesn't sound too right, huh? There's chat. Finally, sheesh. Whoop. Come on. Tilt. Tilt. Tilt! The secret word of the day is tilt! Come on! Ah! This fucking chair! Ah! No! Ah! I fell through the cracks in the goddamn chair! Ah! Like, after so many hours, no progress was made! That's it! This is stupid. It is so stupid. Oh, this is so fucking insanely hard. You know what? Fuck it. Fuck it. Fuck it all. I've had it. I've spent fucking too much time on one goddamn mission. This wouldn't be so goddamn hard if I had a goddamn controller. Maybe I wouldn't be in the shape that I'm in. Just checking under. I was looking if there was anything special on the floor over here. But anyway, just fucking just been wasting my time flopping around on walls and plants. Fucking betraying me and candy getting all over me and just all kinds of assery happening, flying off of walls and just ass, pure ass. And I'm so sick of it. Sick of the ass. Not even good ass. This is like chunky, fucking shitty, rancid ass. This is like the kind of ass you would find at a goddamn. At a goddamn, like, sleazy bar in the back, behind a sleazy bar in a back alley. And, you know that kind of ass has been around a little too long, and it's been, like, out in the sun for, like, far too many hours. It's all wrinkly and shit. This is the kind of ass that we're talking about here. Can I afford to pull that doorknob, by the way? That would be cool. Nope, cannot. Cannot be done. Anyway, back to the ass. This game has so much ass in it that there's an assception. There is like three asses, one inside the next. That's how much ass there is in this game. Literally, I have spent, 2 hours on this goddamn game and have not made a fucking lick of progress. This game can lick all of that ass inside all of that ass. So it can lick the third ass, inside the other ass. That's how much this fucking shitty-ass game can lick the ass of the ass. Fucking ass game. Jesus. I'm going fucking crazy because of this game. This fucking game drove me to nuts. It wasn't like I was nuts to begin with. Well, I've always kind of been nuts, but this game drove me more nuts than I normally am. Let's see if I can actually make it with no pressure. No question. If I don't make it, I'm just gonna climb the goddamn thing this time. Oh, well. Well, now. See, that would have really pissed me off. Game. Ooh, you better get me out of that box. It didn't drive me nuts. It drove me too nuts. Which is, I don't normally go nuts, but, you know, when the game drives, I am nuts. Excuse me, I am staring at what I think might be a mosquito flying through my room. Perhaps. I don't think so. It looks awfully big. Give me a sec. I'm just staring at this mosquito. The mosquito is more interesting than this goddamn game right now. So, it's not. It's a moth. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, yeah. This game didn't make me nuts. It drove me nuts. I've always been nuts, and it drove me to the nuts. Because I didn't want to go nuts, but this game fucking drove me to them. It was like, get in the car, we're taking a ride, we're going to the nuts. We're going nuts, we're going to the nuts. Do you want to stop at the store on our way there? Because we can do that, bud. But I was like, no, I don't want to even go outside today. I'm busy, I got other things to do. And the game was like, no, you gotta go because you're required to. I'm like, I don't want to. Seriously, can't I just stay at home today? Because I'm freaking not feeling too hot about going outside. But the game insisted because it was paying my rent at the time and told me it owed me a favor. So yeah. This game is like a really bad renter or whatever. Hey, this actually toasts me. Toasted me. Get on there. Get on it.
You're gonna have to figure out what you're gonna do over here.
You're a word. You're a ward. Like a psycho ward. Ha ha!
You're a wart.
Oh! You're a toad. No, I'm not no wart. Oh! Stop! You bastard. You're so mean. That was Mimo. Let's see. Burn. Burning nuts. No, that was not. Oh shit, I see what's going on here. That was me ma, not me pa. Can I like... Come on! Come on! Stop it! Oh.
Do you have a clean shirt for work, or is it?
I think there's one clean shirt for work. I know I have one in the laundry.
There's one on top of there, that's where I was wondering.
I think that's the clean one. The one sitting on my dresser?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yay! I'm toasted.
It's over.
It's over. It's falling really slowly, like, epically, like, my feels, all of my feels right now. That took way too long, and it should not have required as much effort as it did. Going through puberty, even though I'm 28, or 27, but I'm be 28 in about a month. I'm really fucking old, I know. You old fart! I'm not sure what to do. Probably nothing. I'm probably fucking done with this game. Done with it. At least tonight. Shopping list. Bread, bagels, baguettes, crisp bread, sandwiches, goats, bread leader. Bread leader? Aw, man. Crow says he won't be off until, like, an hour from now. That's way too late for me to stream. Also, I just noticed that one of the sticky things that goes on the back of my wireless keyboard came off, and it's now sitting on the table. Oops! I forgot my wireless... Shit. I don't want to become sandwich! I accidentally pressed the keyboard on my wireless one, trying to put the sticker back on. Help me! Give me a sec. Give me one moment. Let's see. Yeah, he's doing night shift, so that's why he's taking forever to get home. And he might not be back for another hour. So, yeah, he's definitely not going to be back for another hour. I don't want to play this mission! I should really have somebody that would do some work. I need somebody to, like, do highlights for me, because I'm too lazy. I'm not really lazy, but my plate is full. I'm normally, like, I'm trying to do videos, and I'm trying to make the review videos. Those take a lot of time. While trying to juggle, while trying to prepare for trips and shows for juggling, while also trying to do streams, and then put streams on YouTube, and fighting YouTube for my money, because AdSense is a bunch of bullshit. And everything else, and trying to get to be an official streamer, so that official partner of Twitch or whatever, and it's just a bunch of shit. I just go through shit every day. I've got so much to do. Not only that, but I physically gotta keep cleaning my room, and you know, everything else. I keep cleaning everything, and keeping everything maintained in the house. It's just, like, barely enough time for me. But I like doing this sort of stuff, but it's just, like, I don't have the gumption, and I don't have the time to be constantly, doing highlights, and fixing streams up, or not fixing streams, but putting streams up online. And I just don't have the money to hire anybody, and I don't, I don't have, I also gotta work too, because I need the money, and I don't have good internet, so I can't just be like, okay, I can take the recorded video and put it all online, and it won't take no time. Nah, I gotta, it takes so long to upload things, and it takes up so much energy or so much power from the internet that it takes all day to upload 1 hour long stream. So I have to use Twitch to upload videos from Twitch to my YouTube. So that's how that works. Okay. Oh, I forgot to change the ticker. God damn it. I forgot the fucking ticker again. The ticker. The ticker. I forgot the ticker. I forgot the ticker. Ugh, damn it. Oh well. I knew I felt like I was forgetting something, and I was right. Ah, damn it. It's okay. This will be going to YouTube probably by tonight or tomorrow. I kind of do it whenever I feel like. Whenever I feel like I get the gumption to fill out all the information on the YouTube videos. Because I gotta put up all the dang tags, and that I just hate writing descriptions and tags. It's annoying. I find it annoying. I'd like to do things like this instead, where I just play the video game and try to be funny and do the commentary. Or if I'm going to make a video, I'm going to do it right by making it, doing all the editing and stuff. However, it's the tags and everything else that's a pain in the ass. So, I think I might call it now. I'm thinking about calling it now because I know he's not going to come in to play Ori. Or be able to come in to see me play Ori of the Blind Forest. I'm actually going to quit the game from now while I decide whether to keep playing video games. Or if it's going to be getting a little too late to play video games because I got people going to be going to bed soon. Do I have anything? Oh, well, I do have Holy Potatoes, but I mean, probably won't be playing it that much or that long. What say you, chat? While you do that, I'm feeling a bit tired now. Oh, I feel drained. The game drained me. The fucking game drained me. Killed me. It killed me dead. Ugh. It's been 3 hours. I've been streaming for quite a while now. I still gotta do more work on the review video, and I'm also gonna have to now upload the streams to YouTube and fix those up. Yeah, I'm gonna end the stream now, and then we'll start up playing hopefully Ori of the Blind Forest tomorrow. And yeah. I'm going to fix up the two videos that are going to be put up on YouTube probably tonight or tomorrow. So, and I'll be streaming tomorrow, and I do have work tomorrow, so unfortunately I'm going to do the work tonight because I'll have to be working by 11 o'clock and it'll be an outside shift tomorrow. So, yeah, I'm going to get this all fixed. Also, I need to install my new desk. It's actually sitting right there in my eyesight. I got a new desk and everything, fixed it up. So I can put my computer in a new spot and fix everything up here. Alright, so you guys, hopefully you enjoyed the stream. And you all have a nice night, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!